Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. Thank you so much for like, share and subscribe to our channel. If you are new visitor, definitely go to our channel and see all the videos. If you like those videos, click the subscribe button and also click the bell button so that you will get the notification. Okay, let's go to the today's topic. In this video, we will discuss how to create user registration form in ASP.NET MVC 5 application. This is the final output of this tutorial. Here we have header user registration. Here we used three columns, username, password and isadmin. This confirm password we added in our model only. Okay, now let's submit this form without entering username and password. Here you will get the error message. This field is required like that. Okay, if I enter some text, username and a password, admin. Okay, if I click outside of this form, here you can see the error message, confirm password and password do not match. Okay, if I enter some text, okay, it should match with the password text box. Now, if the user is admin, you can click the checkbox, then click the submit button. Here we have the success message, registration successful. Okay, if I enter same name again, same username. Okay, click the submit button. So it display the message. Username already exists. Okay. Now let's start creating this application. Yeah. Let's create new project in Visual Studio 2013. Click here, new project. Yeah. Select web under Visual C Sharp. Then select ASP.NET web application. Then name your application here, user registration. Then select the location where you want to save this application. Now click on OK. Here select MVC template, then keep other options as it is, then click on OK. Here we have created a user registration application successfully. Now let's create database for this application. To create a database in Server Explorer, right click on data connection, then click on create new SQL Server Database. Here we have to provide the instance connection. It for me it's dot. Okay, here database name will be user registration db, then click on OK. See here, we have created our new database successfully. Now let's add tables inside this tables folder. So right click, add new table. See here in this table, it has column ID column. It's the primary key for this table. Okay, I want to edit this column name as user ID. It's of the type integer. Okay, now username, data type varchar 15, then password varchar 15, then isadmin, its data type bit, and uncheck this checkbox, it won't allow nulls. Okay, now rename this table. Table name will be user. Okay, see here, user ID is a primary key for this table. So I want to make this same column as identity column for this table. So go to user ID column properties here. Here, expand this identity specification, then set this is identity to true. Okay, it will start with one and increment by one for every new record insertion. This increment operation will take care of the SQL server itself. Okay, now we want to save this table. To save the table, we have to click update here. It's preparing update script. Okay, after click on this update database button, our database updated successfully. Okay, now let's add ADO.NET entity model for this database. For that, right click on models folder, then click on add ADO.NET entity model. Our model name will be DB model. Then click OK. Yeah, select EF designer from database. Then click on next. Yeah, if you are using username and password to connect SQL server, you can use the second option. Otherwise, select the first option. Then after creating ADO.NET entity model, there will be a class with this name. We will be using an object of this class to interact with this database. Okay, I want to rename this class name as DB models. Then click on next. In this window, we have to choose our database objects that we want to add it in our ADO.NET entity model. Okay, in this database tables, we have only one table, so that's why I check this tables checkbox. Okay, then click on finish. Okay, this is how the entity model table looks like. Now go to models folder. Inside this models folder, you can see DB model class. Inside that, we have user class. It contains properties which is respective to our database table user. Okay, this is auto generated by the ADO.NET entity model. Okay, we have one more class here, dbmodel.context.cs file. Inside this, you can see the class name DB models. I told you this class while creating ADO.NET entity model. Okay. We will be using an object of this class to interact with this database. Okay, now let's add controllers to this application. So right click on controllers folder, then click on add controller. Yeah, select MVC file controller empty. Then controller name will be user, then click on add. Okay, here we have the user controller. Inside this controller, we have only one default action method. That method name index. By default, this is a get method. Okay, I want to edit this action name, add or edit, with a parameter int id. I will set the default value as 0. Okay, here I will use this class. So we have to add this namespace of user class in our user controller here using okay. Here I will call the user class function, user object name user equals new user. Okay, we will pass this object to our view. Okay, now let's create a view for this add or edit action method. So right click, add view. In this view, keep view name as it is and a template will be create and model class will be user. We are using this view as a layout page, then click on add. Okay, here we have created add or edit view. Okay, now let me run this application without debug mode by pressing Ctrl plus F5. This is how the user registration page looks like. Okay, now go back to view. Here, see here, view bag title, add or edit. Okay, here we have not specified any layout page, so it will take the share in default layout page, this layout.cshtml. See here, view bag.title is the same. Okay, now go back to browser. See here, it displaying the header add or edit. So I want to change this to user registration. Then it displays two header, add or edit and user. So I want to remove this second header. Okay, then enter some text in password text box. So it displaying the exact character what I entered. Okay, normally password text box will not show the text which we have entered. So instead it will display the dots or any symbols like that. Okay, then I want to remove this backlist. Okay, then I want to change this create text to submit. Then I want to add one more label and text box for confirm password. These are the changes I am going to make now. Okay, go back to view. Here, add or edit view. First, I am going to change this add or edit to user registration Then I want to remove this second header user. Okay, save this, reload the page. See, the user registration title changed here, so here we have to change this title also. In h2 tag, user registration. Okay, now save this and reload the page. Okay, now the title has changed. Now I want to remove this back to list. Okay, here is the link to go back to list. Let's remove it. Okay, now I want to change this create text to submit. Here we can change the value to submit. Okay, now reload the page. Okay, it's working fine. Next, I'm going to add space between this user and name. Okay, go to user class. Here we will use display name attribute. We have to add namespace for this attribute component model. Inside this, within double quote, user with space and then name. Okay, reload. See here, we have the space between user and name. Okay, next I'm going to add label and text box for confirm password. Before that, we have to add one more property in this user class. Here, property, it's of this type string, and then property name will be confirm password. Okay, copy this line, display name, pasting here, then confirm password. Here we have to give the space between confirm and password. Okay, now let's add controls for this confirm password property in add or edit view. Here, copy this password div and pasting below that. Here, instead of password, we will use confirm password. So copy this, replace this password. Here, okay, save this. Okay, now build the solution using shortcut control shift F9. So F10. Okay, then reload this page. See here, we have confirm password label under text box. Okay, now check this password text box. So it's displaying the text, enter the text. So instead of this, we have to display the dots. For that, in user class, we will use an attribute data type. So for this attribute, we have to add namespace, component model dot data annotation. So inside this data type dot password. Okay, copy this and paste in below that. Okay, now save this and reload the page. Now entered some character in password text box. Okay, now it works fine. Okay, now this user registration page is ready. Okay, now let's add client side validation for this user registration form. In this form, username and password are mandatory field, and confirm password we should match this password with this password. If they match, we will enter the user details into our table, else we will show the error message. Okay, for validation we have to add the plugin. So right click, manage NuGet packages. Here, jQuery validation. Here, I am going to install this Microsoft jQuery unobtrusive validation. Okay, install this one. Here, click I accept. Okay, now the package installed successfully. Now close this window. Okay, now inside this script folder, you can see the jQuery library file and jQuery validate and jQuery validate.unobtrusive.min.js file. Okay, now add or edit layout. Here it added the bundles of jQuery and bundles of bootstrap. Okay, here we have the bundles jQuery validation script file. Okay, now let's add a required attribute here. Error message equal this field is required. Okay, copy this. This is for same for password also. So pasting here. For confirm password, we have to compare this password with this password. Okay, for that we will use compare inside this within double quote. We have to compare this password. This is the compare validator. This is how we can compare this password with confirm password text box. Okay, now build the solution using shortcut Ctrl Shift B. Now reload this page. Now try to submit this form without entering the user details. Okay, now validation is working fine. This field is required. Okay, if I enter username, trail and password admin. Okay, if I click out of this form, okay, it shows the error message confirm password. Okay, if I enter ADM, okay, it's showing the error message. Now I entered correct password. Okay, the error message doesn't displaying here. Okay, if the user is admin, you can check this checkbox, then click on this submit button. It will insert into user table. So for that we have to create one more controller, sorry, action method in this user controller. Okay, here public action result add or edit. Okay, here we will pass this user class and then object. Okay, here return view. Okay, by default all the actions are get method. So we want this action method as the post action method. For this we will use HTTP post attribute. Okay, in this action method we will use this using statement. Here we will pass the db models object db equal new db models. Okay, here db dot users dot add. If I enter username, password and all the user related details, then if I click on the submit button, it will post the data from this form into post action method, this action method. Okay, then here the data will be binded to this this object. So we will pass this object to here. Then we will call this db.saveChanges function. Okay, in add or edit view, in begin form function we have to pass the post URL. So it will be add or edit. Then second parameter will be the controller name user, then form method dot post. Okay, now the final will clear this model state dot clear. Okay, after a successful user registration, we have to show the message. Success message equal registration successful. Yeah, in return view we are add or edit, then here we'll send a new user class. Okay, now save this. Now we need to modify this add or edit view to show the notification message. Okay, here copy this submit button type do, then pasting below that. Here instead of this call MD class, I will use call MD2. Okay, instead of this submit button, I will use label with class label success. Okay, here will display the message view back dot this success message. Okay, now save this, build the solution and reload this page. Okay, now enter username and password 1234 and then confirm password 1234. If I enter 12 only, if I click, so it's not valid. Enter 34, now it's valid. Okay, now check this checkbox is admin, then click this submit button. Here we have the success message, registration successful. Now let's check in our database. Right click on user table, select top 1000 rows. Here we have the record of username virtual. Okay. Before inserting the user details into this user table, we have to check the username already exists in this user table or not. If the username exists, we have to display the message username already exists, such that. Okay. If not exist, we can insert the record into this table. Okay. For that, I have to modify this post action method in user controller. Here first we will check if db.users dot any, if any username is exist with the username. Okay, x such that x dot username equals this entered username. Here if exist means we will display the error message, duplicate message equal username already exists. And then we'll return view add or edit with this model object user. If not exist, we'll insert the user record into our table. Okay, now let's check it, build the solution and reload this page. See here, if I enter the same username and the password admin, then click this submit button, it has to show the error message. I think we have to modify the add or edit view to display the duplicate message. Okay, go back to view. Here copy this success message due and pasting below that. Here instead of this success message, replace this with duplicate message. Okay, now save this. Now enter the same username and password, then click this submit button. So here it's displaying the message username already exists. Okay, now you can check the database. here we have only one record, so it's not inserting. Okay, if I change this username by adding 1 year, then click the submit button. Now we have the success message, registration successful. Then check this DB. Here we have the second record. Now it's inserting the record. Okay, that's it guys. In this video we have discussed how to create user registration form in ASP.NET MVC 5 application using SQL Server Database. This project source code link given below in video description. I hope you like it. Do share this video with all your friends. Also like and subscribe to this channel. Thank you so much for watching this video and see you there in next video. Bye.